Hello and welcome back to another video here at Pragmatic Works. My name is Manuel Quintana, and I'm sure some of you here, or maybe you're going in this direction in the Power BI service, some more managerial administrative tasks, are familiar with subscriptions, right? These are items that you can set up for your employees, or you can kind of have them be aware of how to do it for themselves. But this allows us to effectively schedule emails, notifications of our reports. So in a timely fashion, they can get a nice little link. Here's the report, head on over there. Or of course you can set it up so as soon as the report gets refreshed to send this once a day, they get a link on this, right? Subscriptions have been around for a while, but in this recent month here in August, there's been a new feature that's been made generally available, which gives us a second option around subscriptions. And that's what we're gonna be talking about in today's session. So let's, of course, head out here into our browser of choice. We're gonna head over to the Power BI service and talk about these new dynamic subscriptions. I believe the actual term they use here is gonna be called dynamic per recipient. Let's head on over and check it out. So here I just have the documentation around this new feature, right? This was actually introduced at the beginning of 2024. In January, they unveiled this to us as a preview feature available to us in the Power BI service. So we actually have had quite a bit of time. So some of you might be familiar with this, but I think it was around August 19th on the official Power BI release blog, whenever they talk about the feature summary, they included this dynamic per recipient feature as being generally available now in the service. So everyone can take advantage and use it as long as you meet the prerequisites. And in this case, the only prerequisite here, as we can see if we scroll down a smidge, is going to be that we're going to need to have a valid workspace using capacity. So at the time of this recording, that would include a fabric capacity, a premium capacity, as well as possibly if you have a fabric trial, there's technically a fabric trial capacity. Any workspace that is leveraging one of these three types of licensing methods will be eligible for this dynamic per recipient option. So that's kind of step one. You know, if you're not in that space, you don't have any sort of capacity licensing, then you won't be able to take advantage of this feature. So that's the main thing. Also, another consideration, of course, is we're gonna have actually a set, like a secondary data set, if you will. The way this works, and if for anyone here who comes from maybe an SSRS background, right, on-prem SSRS, you might remember data-driven subscriptions. There's a little bit of familiarity here, right? A little deja vu. We're gonna actually be needing to use an actual data set to drive this dynamic per recipient feature. So when we go through the process, it literally says, what data set are you gonna use to take advantage of this feature? So in that data set, we have to have some relevant details and information available, right? And we'll look through that and we'll go through it. I have a little sample data set, super simple, so that you can see how this actually functions. So we are gonna need a data set. And of course, we will need build permissions on that data set. In this demonstration, of course, since it's my data set, I obviously have full access to it, but if someone else curates, let's say a distribution list data set, you're gonna need build access to that. And then the last thing is, in order to set up subscriptions for anyone in your organization, you needed to be at minimum a contributor or higher member inside your organization. So this still is there, either a contributor, member, or an admin within the workspace for the report that you're trying to attempt to set up this dynamic per recipient subscription. So those are gonna be your prerequisites. Capacity, build on the contact or email list data set, and either contributor, member, or admin inside the workspace that you're setting up the subscription for, the report, right? So that's what we need. You can always check this out. You can go to the documentation for yourself. There's a bunch of stuff in here, but let's just dive in and take a look at this in practical use, right? So in this case, this is just the report I'm gonna use. Anybody's taken maybe, let's say, a dashboard in a day, you might be familiar with this, right? This is the report you end up creating, just a basic report that I'm gonna use so I can also showcase filtering, right? We're gonna use this page. We have a report here that, as you can see, has various different countries for filtering. So I'm gonna show you an example where I'm gonna set this up. I'm gonna send multiple emails out. So I have a couple of accounts that we can look at. It'll send that subscription like normal with a link. We can choose if we want an attachment, what format should that attachment be, put a custom item in the subject line. And once again, who it's being emailed is driven by a data set, right? So we're gonna look at this together. So this will be the report that ends up getting emailed out, and we're actually gonna use this option here. But real quick, I'm gonna show you the basic nature of what I've created as far as a data set, right? Now, the underlying source that you can use for this, of course, could literally be anything. I just created a very simple Excel workbook, just created a table in there. As you can see, it has four columns, and I just put in this specific information. You can see I put an email address. This is who I'm gonna send it to. the subject line that I'm going to be placing in here, the column that I'm going to be using for filters. Now, in this case, I just called this filter, but of course I could have called this like country filter, and then we could have had like a year filter, right? You could potentially have multiple columns for the different types of attributes that you want to be filtering on. When we get into the process of setting up the dynamic per recipient subscription, you literally have a choice of hitting, okay, I want to add a dynamic filter, plus which column from the data set for this report is going to map to which column from this data set here, the contacts list data set. So you can definitely have more. I just have one in this example, but just imagine whatever you need, you can put in here. But it's all about having this data set. So it's kind of a new piece of this process, right? And lastly, you know, obviously, optionally, you don't have to put attachments, but in this case, I'm going to showcase how I can say yes. For this person, they should get a PDF. For this person, they'll get a PowerPoint. And you can see for the bottom, I've included no attachment there, right? Just in case, just to show. I did this through an Excel workbook. I straight up brought it into Power BI Desktop, and I have now deployed this out to a workspace. It doesn't have to be necessarily in the same workspace as the report that you're creating the subscription. Remember, the minimum requirement is you simply have to have build permissions on this data set wherever it resides. As we're going to see in a moment, it literally gives me a list, almost like the one like data hub where you get a list of available actual data sets. Same thing is going to present itself here. So we've created our email list, distribution list, contact list, whatever you want to call it. We've deployed it out somewhere in the service. I've got build access to it. I'm in this workspace, which has the report I'm interested in creating the subscription for. And I am, in this case, an admin. And this, as you can see, premium capacity, right? So I go to the report in question. So I'm going to head right on over here to my report. We can hit subscribe. And because it's a premium capacity, as soon as I hit this little button, there's our new choice, right? Like I said, it's technically been around since January, but it's only now become GA. And I can hit dynamic per recipient, and it simply says, okay, where's your data set? Where is the recipient data, right? So in my case, you can see there's my contact list. If you needed to filter this, you absolutely could. But you can see I can go across various different workspaces here. So once again, this could exist anywhere. You just have to have build permission. So I click my contact list. I go ahead and hit next, and it says choose the data that you want to map to the subscription, right? It gives us information. So which columns from this data set are you going to be using for these potential options? You don't have to use this, as you're going to see, as we get choices. You can kind of statically put stuff. You can say retrieve it from the data set, right? And sometimes there's some pre-configured choices too for like a drop-down list. In our case, I am going to go ahead and choose all of the columns. We actually get a preview of that information on the screen, and then we can move to the next step. It's a really nice wizard that we can kind of just walk through. So now it says, okay, what is going to be the name of the subscription? Who are we emailing this to? Do you want to enter it manually? We know this. If you're going to do this, might as well go for the original type of subscription. But I could see a use case where, yeah, you know, these four people are going to be the case, and then you're going to drive it through data set for other purposes. But in this case, I can hit the drop down and say, I want to get the list of recipients from my data set. And specifically, it gives me the table.column name. So in this case, contact table. Email. We've made this dynamic. You can see this will be the visual representation that this has been done in that sense. It's tied to the underlying data set, right? Subject. If I want to put in something manually, I absolutely could. But I went through the time and in my data set have included a subject. Message. I'll put something here. This is at the moment not set to be dynamic, but I could imagine more of these things will become available to map it from a data set. I could definitely see that coming. So enjoy your report. What page do you want to share? Technically, if I had put this in here, if I had multiple pages and I only wanted to put a specific page to the user, I could. This is one of the examples where I did not include this, but as you can see, we could indicate very much so. So I'll just use the default one so I can more accurately display the filter choices. Do I want to include a link to the report? Yes or no. Report praise preview, sure. And then if we continue, you can see down below, attach full report. This actually has an option, right? Get from data, in which I'm going to choose the contact table.attachment. Now, the only one you'll notice that we haven't used yet is this one here, the contact table.filter. That will be coming up shortly. So I select this option. Everything that I want to configure dynamically is set. So I can simply hit next and go to the section for mapping. This is where I mentioned where we can define filters. If I simply hit add filter, I choose literally a list from all of the columns, everything that's available to me inside of the actual original report is available. You can see the table name and all of its columns. Table name, all of its columns. In this case, I'm gonna filter on the geography table, the country column, and say where that equals, the filter value coming from my contact table. And this is just one. But as I mentioned, you could continue to add more depending on whatever filter criteria you've provided in the original data set there. So just the one for me. If we go back and look, I'm sending myself an email. So it should filter that map down to just USA. And then the other secondary item we're going to look at is going to be this PW demo email account, which will have Canada listed. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it as such. I'm going to hit next. Schedule, I'm just going to leave it as whatever, run daily. I'm basically just going to manually kick this off myself here. So I'll just put this here and hit next, and everything's all set. You can review this if you like, but I'm going to go ahead and hit save and close. So now we can see that this is present. It's available to us. What I'm going to do to kind of force the scenario is to expand the subscription and simply go ahead and hit, you can see and review stuff here too, which is cool, but I'm going to go ahead and just simply hit send now. So I'm going to go ahead. This usually takes a moment on the back end to process this. Normally it would kick off at the time frame in question, but like I said, I'm manually going to run this. So let me have this take a moment and then we'll see the results. All right, just checking real quick. It looks like my email has come in. I'm just going to bring this over. So this is the first email that showed up. And as you can see, I chose to have a PDF attachment for me. There it is attached. If we look at the preview, we can see that this has been filtered to just the United States, which is the filter that I had for this email address. But then also, if I go over, let's check and see if the email has been received. It has. This is the other account, which is meant to be a PowerPoint, which it is. And it's meant to, in this case, it's not really showing the sender information. I want to see that preview. You can see this has been filtered to that Canada dot. So this right here is showing us. I can set up a data set. Now just know that the limitations here, right? If we go and revisit the documentation around this, because we looked at the prerequisites, but it should be noted that there actually are some limitations. One of those is that contacts list table, as of right now, is limited to 1,000 recipients, right? So there is a hard code amount that you can go with. It's going to be 1,000 recipients at the moment. Whether this changes in the future, it could be the case, very much so. And you can see all these limits say also, if you set this up, it doesn't actually give them access. So access is a separate thing. That's not a surprise. That's perfectly expected. You can see it only supports single value filters. So it doesn't work with multiple value options. And then also if the name of the columns or tables are changed in the semantic model, naturally that would cause a bit of an issue here. And that makes sense. We know there are some issues with the metadata rigidity that exists with Power BI. I mean, that's like anything. If someone's changing something upstream, then there's going to be issues with the semantic model anyways downstream. So there's no surprise there. I think the biggest thing in conjunction to this right now is, which it's still a pretty high limitation, is the fact that it's 1,000 recipients, and that is the limitation there. But this is a fun, great new thing. If you come from that world of data-driven subscriptions, right, something that existed within paginated or SSRS reports for the on-prem server, then this is really exciting. We saw a dynamic distribution capability for paginated reports in the service, so it's nice to see that come to our traditional Power BI Interactor reports within the service as well. So definitely something to keep an eye on. Once again, it's no longer carrying that preview tag as of this mid-August timeframe. It's time to start taking advantage of this dynamic per recipient subscription feature, which is pretty darn awesome. So as always, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one.